From Burton Coliseum in Lake Charles, Louisiana, it's time for Southland Conference men's college basketball action. Today, it's the McNeese State Cowboys playing host to the Texas State Bobcats. And good afternoon, happy holiday to you, everybody. I'm Tom Franklin, alongside is Neil Raphael. Today, we have two teams that used to be in the same conference in the Southland, meeting for the first time since 2012 as McNeese State entertains Texas State. And Neil, both of these teams have a little bit of similarity in that they've got a lot of questions that still need to be resolved before league play rolls around.
Yes, McNeese State has six new bodies, four of them are freshmen. On the other side of the ledger, Texas State has suffered through a lot of preseason injuries, trying to get back on track today.
When you try and blend in new faces and get things working harmoniously, the emphasis falls on the respective point guards. And we'll look at the point guards for today's ballgame as being the key. First for Texas State, that would be O.J. Black.
Yeah, O.J. Black with 10 points, 5 assists, and only 2 turnovers in 39 minutes against the UTEP Miners.
When you turn the page to McNeese State, they've got six new faces, as Neil mentioned, and the guy who's got to try and blend everybody in is going to be Jemiah Bird.
Yeah, Jemiah Bird off to a great start. 4 games in double figures so far, including 18 against the LSU Tigers.
So it'll be an interesting matchup today to see which one can exert their will and which one can develop the chemistry. We'll have the starting lineups and the opening tip-off for today's ballgame right after this timeout. You. There you go. All right. Okay. Fairly quickly, unless you need us to do something else. And there you see it, Burton Coliseum, Lake Charles, Louisiana. Southland Conference basketball action today between the Texas State Bobcats and the McNeese State Cowboys. Very multifunctional facility here in Lake Charles, and the Cowboys getting ready to open up their own facility here in a couple of years, and they'll be on campus at McNeese State University. Let's take a look at the starting lineups for today's ball game. First of all, for the visiting Texas State Bobcats. And they've had to make a change in their starting lineup. Their leading scorer, Cameron Naylor, out with a broken nose. And so Anthony Roberson moves in at one of the forward spots, along with Amani Gant and Kevin Gilder-Tilbury. O.J. Black, who we talked about in the open, and Ethan Montalvo will be in the backcourt with him as well. Now for the McNeese State Cowboys, their point guard, Jemiah Burr, who we talked about, will have to get everybody in motion. They really like this young freshman, Jaron Greenwood, had a nice ball game their last time out in the win over Dillard. Lance Poche is a guy they really are looking for to catch fire offensively. Tevin Jackson, a junior college transfer, and Austin Lewis will be manning the post position as you see the players being introduced here. And Neil, as we talked about in the open, questions to be answered here. And as a guy who's been on around basketball for as long as you have and coached it, how important are these early season games to develop your rotation, to develop a team chemistry so that when the games that really count, if you will, your conference games come along, you're ready to go?
Oh, I think they're imperative. You've got to get your rotation down by that first conference game. So it's really important to give everybody a look, find out how deep you're going to be able to go in your bench, whether it be 7, 8, or 9, and just find out what your team's made of and who's going to be able to perform when it's crunch time.
How much can you gain on that from practice compared to when the lights are on like today in today's ball game? How big a difference is it between what you see in practice and what you see on game day?
It's a world of difference. Practice is one thing, you're going against each other, but when you're out there on the floor, you have competition, you're seeing how you react to certain situations, it's night and day, Tom.
Our referees for today's ball game, Byron Jarrett is our lead official, and his assistants are John St. Clair and Andrew Walton. McNeese State, the home team, dressed in the home gold uniforms trimmed in white and royal blue. And the Texas State Bobcats, the visiting team, dressed in the burgundy and gold uniforms. And these two teams used to be members of the Southland Conference. They used to play each other for quite some time. First time they've gotten together since 2012. And thus far, McNeese has the advantage in the series, and they really have the advantage here at Burton Coliseum. We'll see if it holds true today. Center jump, controlled by Imani Gant, and it'll be Texas State with the ball moving left to right across your screen. Montelvo finds the cutter. And that was Roberson, had to give it off. Shot in the lane, partially deflected. Ball knocked toward the corner. Out of bounds. Last touch by Texas State. And so McNeese will get their first opportunity.
Yeah, nice help in the paint by McNeese of being able to slide over and help stop the penetration.
Jemiah Burr, 6 foot junior, on the far sideline. Here's Poche. Poche's got some big shoes to fill. From DeShedrick Guidry from a year ago. Burr throws that one away. Something he doesn't do very much is turn the ball over, but he committed one there.
Now communication between him and Tevin Jackson.
He's saying Poche is stepping in for a guy who was close to double-double in over 20 games per season. So those are big shoes to fill for Poche, who saw limited action a year ago. On the block is Gant. Kicks it out. Gilder Tilbury with a drive to the basket is fouled.
Tilbury with a nice move to the basket. Will double down by McNeese, forcing them to pass it out, and the drive by Texas State.
Tevin Jackson with the foul. Two-shot opportunity for Gilder Tilbury. First one on the way and our first point of the ball game. On the season, he hasn't missed from the free throw line. I hope I didn't jinx him. Thank goodness the announcer jinx didn't work there. 2-0 in favor of Texas State, just underway, a minute gone by here at Burton Coliseum. Nice extended man-to-man defense for Texas State, but that's something that Danny Casper's teams have been known for a long, long time. Poche kicks it out. Burr open for three on the right wing. Off the iron, no good. Good positioning, a rebound by Gant. He'll lead the charge down the floor. They get it to Montalvo for three. Off the iron, no good. Block out underneath, last touch by. They say Roberson got it last and it belonged to McNeese State.
A nice job of Texas State of swinging the ball in transition. The open look by Montalvo, but comes up a little long on the shot. But a great job, Tom, when they reverse the ball against the pressure.
Montalvo doing a good job on the three so far at 56%. 5 out of 9 coming in. Here's a three for Burr. He'll get it from the left corner. And McNeese State is on top, 3-2.
Nice penetration and kick by McNeese State to finish at the rim for Burr.
Travel on Gant, trying to work down low on the block, left side. Gant kind of an enigma for Danny Casper. He's a great offensive player. He says he has all the ability in the world to be a first-team player in the Sun Belt Conference. He says, but he needs to do a much better job rebounding and defending. Jump hook in the lane by Poche comes up short, and Gant's got another rebound. There's back-to-back ones. Long down the floor. Good save by Montalvo, picked up by Gant. Now they'll swing it back outside and settle it down.
Both teams doing a nice job of early of covering up the paint and forcing the perimeter shots.
Gant doubled on the right block, has to come away to the three-point line. Here's Black with a step back jumper from the free throw line. No good, and a good clear on the inside. Another three on the way and good. Jaron Greenwood.
Nice job of Greenwood of surveying the defense. Had a little room there. Stopped and popped from three.
Young freshman from Houston they like a lot. There's a steal. Kick it off for Burr. Missed the left-handed bunny. The follow is no good. Tipped again, no good. Oh, three chances and couldn't get it to fall in transition. Back the other way is Gilder Tilbury. His shot is short. Taken down by Craig McFerrin. McFerrin in the starting lineup in favor of Austin Lewis. That's a late switch that Dave Simmons made for us. McFerrin is a fifth-year senior. Missed all of last year with a torn labrum, but a big guy and a big body at 6'7", 250.
Yeah, in transition there, forcing the action. And so far, Tom, McNeese State doing a nice job on the glass.
McFerrin from the free throw line has got it down. And just like that, it's an 8-2 ball game in favor of the Cowboys. So far, the start is exactly what Dave Simmons was hoping for from his team, dictating the tempo of the game, moving it up and down the floor. As you can tell, Texas State would like to be a little bit more deliberate. Jump stop in the lane and a nice dish by Black, and he finds Roberson for the basket.
He did. Drew the defense in, the double team, and the dip down for the two.
It's about 4 minutes gone by. 8-4 is our score in favor of McNeese. They've got the ball in the yellow uniforms. Goal to be particular. McFerrin's shot from the left wing is no good, and it's cleared by Black. Black will penetrate, dish to Roberson. He'll lay it off for Gant, and a nice layup underneath. Good ball movement there on the break by Texas State.
Yeah, great ball movement, the baseline drive, and the finish at the rim.
So now the Bobcats back to within two. Burr going to try and work on Black in the lane. A runner is no good. Gant clears another rebound. He's been strong on the defensive board so far. Black through the lane. Back to Montalvo. Swing it. Roberson will drive off the glass for two and one. A blocking foul underneath is the call against Poche. That'll take us to an official's timeout with 15-15 to play in the opening quarter. Nice end-to-end action here as we're all tied at 8 apiece. .445 going by. We're all even at 8 apiece. Texas State and McNeese State here at Burton Coliseum in Lake Charles on this Saturday after Thanksgiving afternoon. Three-point opportunity by Anthony Roberson. He's got five of their nine. And the Bobcats back on top. Both teams a little cold from the field. 3-for-8 for Texas State. 3-for-9 for McNeese. But McNeese has made 2 out of 3 from long range, Neil.
Yeah, they've been able to stroke it from the left side as well as the right.
Nice drive through the lane by Tevin Jackson. Couldn't get the roll. And Black pulls down the rebound for the Bobcats. Entry pass for Gant is stolen away. McFerrin with a quick hands, and it goes to Greenwood. And the young freshman will bring it up the floor. They look for McFerrin down low against Gant. There's the pass down low, and he muscled it in for two.
Yeah, nice isolation and a mismatch down on the low block for McNeese.
He is a big body down there, and you can see the difference he can make in this McNeese team if he can stay healthy and stay on the floor.
Yeah, posted up, got that big wingspan.
Three ball from the corner is no good from Gilder Tilbury, but last touch by McNeese off the hands of Tevin Jackson.
That's the third turnover for Texas State as well.
See Tevin Jackson there, number 21 from Perth, Western Australia. In the lane, muscled up, no good, rebound tipped out by Gilder Tilbury, but taken away by McNeese. Burr's three is no good.
That's a tough shot from the left corner. I mean, if you make it, it's good. If not, you have no one down there to rebound that ball.
Gant pulls off yet another rebound. Here's Montalvo in the lane. They swing it back to Black. Gant with four early rebounds. Going to the basket with the left hand. It rolled out. He tipped it in.
He did. Tipped it in with his left hand. Nice job on the offensive glass.
In their last official game against UTEP, Gant with 11 points and 4 rebounds and 2 block shots. Adds 4 in the early going. The Bobcats with a 1-point lead. Here's Burr, left wing. Off the mark with the 3.
And Burr likes the corners. Made one from the left corner earlier.
Here's Roberson, pump fake, no drive. Back outside for Gilder Tilbury. Now Black will get him into their offense with 16 on the shot clock. Montalvo back out of the right corner. Clock is down to 5. He's going to try and drive, and Greenwood's going to get a body foul. It'll be his first and McNeese's third.
Call the push on Greenwood. See the isolation and the penetration, the hand check by Greenwood.
Greenwood out of Bel Air High School in Houston. They really like him. And in their last ball game against Dillard, their first win of the season, 16 points and 4 assists. Tevin Jackson checks out, and now Austin Lewis is in, and we get a 3 and a foul. Montalvo aces the basket, and Greenwood's going to get another foul. Or check it, it's not Greenwood, that's number 0, Sean Johnson, and not number 10. So Johnson gets the foul. And a 4-point opportunity here for Montalvo. Don't see many of those.
No, you don't. And it's not just having new bodies. It's having freshmen that are playing major roles in your program for McNeese, and they're stepping up.
Also checking in, number 13, Matthew Moss. See him set the screen there as Poche goes by. Tried for the pick and roll. It was well covered, and they had to go outside for Poche. Now here's Jackson, almost lost it on the far sideline. Shot clock at 5. Poche will take a deep 3. In and out, no good. Rebound poked out of the hands of Montalvo by Lewis, and Lewis is going to get the foul. That's now 5 team fouls against McNeese, and we still got 12:32 left in the first half.
We'll see the shot attempt and the battle for the ball, the 50-50, and they're going to call the foul that time.
You know, Lewis had the inside position, but it was a long rebound, so he had to go back into Montalvo, who was behind him. And that created the foul. Montalvo, 3 off the cut, no good. Rebound to Gilder Tilbury, and a new chance for the Bobcats to build on their 5-point lead, largest for them in the ballgame. McNeese led it by 6 at 1 point early. Driving the baseline, rejected was McCray. The ball comes back out and saved at the midcourt stripe by Gilder Tilbury. And yet another chance for the Bobcats.
Yeah, McNeese with 2 solid blocks.
And carrying the ball violation against Black.
Yeah, nice inside defense by Lewis and Potier.
A little run for Texas State as they're on a 13-2 run to take a 5-point lead with 11:50 left here in the opening half.
Have you been thinking about- about diversifying with gold but don't know how? Hi, I'm Mike Fulgens, president of Universal Coin and Bullion. As an award-winning nationwide dealer, we help clients get the answers they need to discover the beauty, security, and strength of gold in their portfolio.
Call us today at 866-UCB-GUIDE to receive our award-winning gold guide free. That's 866-822-4843.
McNeese is more than higher education. It's a place where engineering students develop robots to aid in disaster relief around the world. Where agriculture students and faculty work with physicians to conduct groundbreaking research in arthritis treatment. McNeese is more than a four-year college. It's a place to invest in yourself and create the life and future that you want. McNeese is more than a university. McNeese is home. Learn more at McNeese.edu.
The Southland Conference is 4,200 student athletes from 13 member institutions competing in 17 NCAA Division I sports. We are Southland Strong.
.11:50 to play, opening half. And Texas State with a 5-point lead at 15-10 over McNeese. And a chronic problem showing its head in the early going here for McNeese State. Dave Simmons' team continues to find trouble finding the basket. He said, I like the way our team is shooting the basketball and where they're taking their shots. We just can't get them to fall. And such is the case, just 4-14 to get started today.
And also the rebound battle, 15-6 now in favor of Texas State.
Long three by Sean Johnson, no good. Rebound poked out of Lewis's hands and recovered by Bobby Conley, who has checked in. So here comes O.J. Black. The run, as we mentioned, 13-2. It was 8-2 McNeese, and now it's 15-10. Strong to the basket on the baseline was Gilder Tilbury, a rejected but a foul. And Lewis will pick up the foul. That'll be his second.
Wow, what a strong move to the rim.
So Gilder Tilbury, 1 out of 2 from the line. Now he is 3 for 3.
The fifth shot from the free throw line. Fifth free throw attempt for Texas State. McNeese not yet at the line.
And rolls out. That's his first miss of the year. Rebound out of bounds. Last touch, they say, by McCray for Texas State, so to belong to McNeese.
And part of that is due to second chance opportunities for Texas State so far in this contest.
So here come the Cowboys trying to find their rhythm offensively. It's going to be the young freshman Jaron Greenwood running the point. Dishes off to James Harvey, another freshman who is in. We get a whistle and shuffle in the feet was Lewis. Turnover. And the turnover, that's only the second for McNeese. But when you combine that with being out-rebounded, as Neil mentioned, 15-6 and only shooting at 28%, you find yourself staring at a 6-point deficit. You're lucky to be that.
Yeah, and then team fouls, 6-1 in favor of Texas State.
Here's Black down low for Roberson. Strong move is rejected, and the rebound cleared by Austin Lewis.
Yeah, he tried to wrap it around. Really should have gone straight up with it.
Poche in the lane for Lewis. They tried to dump it down low for Moss, and they couldn't find it. Another turnover. And here come the Bobcats. Bobby Conley, who had a nice ball game in the exhibition game against Oklahoma Panhandle State. And off the glass for two was O.J. Black for his first points of the game.
Nice ball reversal that time by Texas State. And O.J. to the basket for two.
Under 10 minutes to play here in the first half, and it's been all McNeese State after the opening 4 minutes. And McNeese has gone ice cold from the floor in addition to turning the ball over. Here's Moss for three. Another one clangs off the iron. And Connolly clears. Back the other way comes Black for the Bobcats. Connolly from out top, he shuffled the feet.
And one thing that that Texas State has done so far, they stopped the transition opportunities by McNeese. First couple of opportunities, they had a chance, but they shut it down.
Saw the double clutch there by Connolly. So Imani Gant comes back in for Texas State. He was key to getting them off to that 8-2 beginning. Let's see if he can provide the spark as he comes back in the ball game. Here's Tevin Jackson from the right wing and goes back outside the arc with it. Trying to get around the screen, can't. Back outside, a three from McFerrin. I don't think that's the shot that Dave Simmons wanted. Rebound taken by Black, poked away by Greenwood.
No, that's a shot you can get any time, Tom.
Here's McFerrin down low. Turnaround from five is no good off the block, but he's fouled going up.
Nice post up by Craig McFerrin. We'll see him on the low block that time. Did a nice job and spun against two defenders and drew the foul. And the first opportunity for McNeese at the free throw line.
Malcolm McCray called for the foul, and McFerrin cannot convert.
No, McNeese needs to reverse the basketball and look for shots on the other side of the floor. They're taking some early shots, Tom, like you mentioned.
Black will get his first breather for Texas State as McFerrin goes 0-for-2 from the line. And checking in is K.J. Malvo, a 5'10 freshman, to run the point. Almost threw it away. Nice recovery here on the sideline by McCray, and ball knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Gilda Tilbury belongs to, or rather, last touch by McNeese. It belongs to Texas State. It'll be Gilda Tilbury to inbounds. So now K.J. Malvo.
2-3 zone by McNeese State.
Down low is Gant against McFerrin, who got a piece and blocked it. And it's taken away nicely by Stephen Ogachuga. Ball knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Greenwood. So they can't take advantage of the opportunity.
Well, three-quarter court pressure by McNeese State.
Ooh, might have gotten the oil with a walk there. Now they back into that 2-3. High pass against Gant, and they say he traveled, moved the pivot foot on the pass. Outside of the high post, posting opportunity.
Couple of turnovers for Texas State against this McNeese zone.
8 minutes to play, 8-point lead for the Bobcats. McNeese hasn't scored in, it seems like, forever. Nice stutter step, but off the side of the backboard was Jackson's shot, and Gant clears another one for the Bobcats.
Yeah, 10-2 run for Texas State.
There's a tip by Greenwood. Ahead he goes for Harvey. His lefty is no good, but he got fouled by Conley. And he will shoot those free throws when play continues. 7:31 to play here in the opening half from Burton Coliseum in Lake Charles, Louisiana. At Texas State on top of McNeese, 18-10. Glad to have you aboard for Southland Conference basketball action this Saturday after Thanksgiving here. Texas State with an 18-10 lead over McNeese State. McNeese ice cold from the floor, making only one of their last nine shots. Elsewhere in the Southland today, Sam Houston State out to a 26-19 advantage in the first half against Southern Utah. Free throw rolls around and is good for James Harvey. Young freshman with his first points of the ball game. Harvey out of Amity, Louisiana. And he goes 2 for 2 from the line. Much needed points.
Full court pressure by McNeese State. 2-2-1.
Hey! Gant tried to muscle it up from a double team. Couldn't get it to go, and McFerrin will clear for McNeese State. We need to double back. That same Houston State, Southern Utah score is football in the first round of the FCS playoffs, and not basketball. See, I've already dropped my football hat and put my basketball hat on. I've forgotten about basketball or football.
You're thinking about all those great games today, all those great matchups.
Yeah, here on the hardwood. That's what I'm thinking about.
Exactly.
Ugochukwu goes to the basket and lays it in. Steven Ugochukwu with his first points off the bench. Here's the drive to the bucket through a double team.
Yeah, against two defenders, able to muscle that in the end off the glass.
Much needed field goal. It's been forever since they made one. They've cut the deficit down to 4. And driving through and getting tied up was Malvo. And on the alternating possession, it'll go over to McNeese State. So the Cowboys play a little defense. Yes. Get a chance to trim even further.
Jaron Greenwood on that tie-up did a nice job on the penetration in the lane.
Malcolm McRae will sit down for Texas State, as will Gant. Kendall Ramlal is in for his first appearance, number 32. Black and Roberson also return to the floor. And Burr is back in now. He's got the ball over on the right sideline for Poche.
Yeah, McNeese needs more movement offensively.
Oh, rolled around and in. Burr with the friendly roll, his second field goal of the game. He made their first bucket, a three-pointer. Hadn't made anything since. We've got 5:45 left here in the half.
Made the first three from the left corner, and that was from the right side.
Two-point game now. Bobcats going a little stale from the floor. Nice pump fake. And a three ball by Ethan Montalvo. His second three of the ball game. He's got 7.
Nice patience by Montalvo. Allowing the defender to fly by and spotting up for the shot.
Burr in the lane. Lost control of the ball.
That was just solid defense by Texas State. Did a nice job of kind of backing off there and allowing him to force that shot.
Montalvo pump fake this time. Can't get the open three, and he'll pass it off for Black, and they'll settle it down. 5 minutes to play and 15 seconds to shoot. Roberson back to Black. Down in the corner for Conley. 2 seconds, Conley launches the three and rattles in and out, no good. Rebound tipped out, and Ramlal will get a new 30 seconds on the clock for the Bobcats. Baseline penetration, strong drive, and 1.
Yeah, but additional opportunities by doing a great job on the glass. 21-9 in favor of Texas State. We'll see the corner drive there and finish at the rim. Comes off a second chance opportunity for the Bobcats.
Kevin Gilda-Tilbury, his first field goal of the game. Now has 4 free throws to go with it for 6 points. And the lead is back out to 8 for the Bobcats at 24-16. With 4:20 to play here in the first half at Burton Coliseum in Lake Charles, Louisiana. Two-three matchup zone, or is it man-to-man? Here's McFerrin. He's tied up from behind by Black, and Texas State's going to get the ball.
Well, that was a great isolation on the low block, Tom, by McFerrin, but he put the ball on the floor. Should have just turned and faced the glass and kissed it off the glass.
Nothing good ever happens when a big man puts the ball on the floor because it lets all the little ants come running to the picnic.
Oh, gosh. How many times have we heard that?
Or some form thereof. Not exactly in those terms. Here's Black on the run to the basket and off the glass with a soft touch.
Again, nice ball movement by Texas State.
Biggest lead of the day so far for the Bobcats at 10. Back the other way for three is Greenwood.
Nice answer. Pull the trigger, Jaron Greenwood from distance.
He's got back-to-back three balls. He's got six, and it's 26-19. 3.5 to play in the first. Black off the mark. Rebound cleared by Poche. Outlet pass on the sideline for Greenwood. Going to go to the basket. Right-hand finger roll is no good, but he got fouled on the drive by Roberson. We'll have free throws when we return. 3:21 to go here, first half. And Texas State with a 7-point lead over McNeese State. .321 to play. Texas State on top of McNeese State, 26-19. And that Southland game, football playoff in the first round, Southern Utah just tied it up at 26 apiece. Got 4 minutes to play in the second quarter. Here, neither team shooting it very well. 36% for Texas State, 9 of 25. And McNeese is 7 of 22 for 32% in the ball game. As Greenwood makes his first trip to the line and rims the free throw, no good.
McNeese 3 of 9 from distance. It's kind of kept them in, 9 of their 19 points from beyond the arc.
But they've been hammered on the backboards at 22 to 11. 1 out of 2 for Greenwood, who has 7 points in the ball game to lead McNeese State. And it's a 6-point lead with 3:20 to go.
McNeese able to get to the free throw line here in the last couple of minutes.
2-2-1, full court zone trap. Almost got the steal from Montalvo, but he got the pass away to Gilda Tilbury. Now they drop back into a 2-3 zone. 3 minutes to play until halftime. Conley to make that Montalvo's three is off the mark, no good.
McNeese has been effective when they're able to get out and transition off the defensive boards. They've had better quality shots.
Jemiah Burr working against Montalvo. Kicked it outside, an offensive foul. Burr with contact against Black.
Yeah, Burr went a little deep in that paint. At that point, you've got to give the ball up a little sooner or go right to the rim against the defense.
First foul against Burr and 18 fouls now against Texas State, but because that's a player control foul, no free throws here. And again, McNeese will set up with full court pressure.
You don't think it works, but you know, you do it three or four times and you force a turnover and it's well worth it.
Here's Black at the top of the arc.
It's kind of saw pressure.
More nuisance trapping than anything else.
Sure.
Montalvo back from outside. They get it in the lane. Back out the three from the left wing is no good by Gilder Tilbury. And McNeese gets a chance to work on this six-point deficit.
And good transition defense by Texas State.
Well, that's one trademark of Danny Casper teams. They're very solid fundamentally. Here's McFerrin in the lane. Had to get rid of it. Burr with a nice crossover. Down low, lefty off the glass is good for Ugochukwu.
A nice feed that time by Burr. Drew the defense in. Nice lay in at the rim.
Two baskets for Steven off the bench. It's a four-point game now. Here's Ramlal with a nice lefty in the lane. Kendall Ramlal with his first basket. Answers for the Bobcats. Down to a minute 20 to go. Right-hander this time is no good for Ugochukwu. Back the other way will come the Bobcats.
Nice balanced scoring by both teams so far here, Tom.
If you look at their overall numbers through their early games of the season, you don't see a standout player. You do see the ball and the point scoring get spread out. Ramlal had to finally give it up in the high post. Down to two, down to one. Desperation shot by Tilbury is no good, but Ramlal with the rebound. He'll dish it back out for Montalvo, and he'll call timeout with 41.3. And there's one of the new changes this year, is oftentimes in the past, we would see a coach call that timeout with the ball in progress. They can't do that anymore. Neil, what do you think of the change that the coaches can only call timeouts when the ball, when a dead ball situation?
I don't know if I like it. I haven't seen enough of it to,
right,
to really
a
make
early.
A judgment, but not sure I'm crazy about that.
Yeah, you
as
coach,
a former coach, you
yeah,
know,
you coach
we
you.
Like that control a little bit, Tom.
Yeah, you're dictators. Yeah, there's no question about that. That's one of the changes. They try to increase the speed of play of the ball games. The NCAA deemed that the men's game needed to be speeded up a little bit. You know, one of the most elementary things that they did was change the shot clock from 35 to 30. I never understood why the men's game had a longer shot clock than the women's game for all those years.
It should be flipped, right?
Absolutely. Now they're both at 30 seconds
yeah,
here for this
we'll
season.
We'll see if they keep whittling it down more towards the NBA, you know, where you get across half and try to shoot the ball.
So 41 seconds to go until halftime. 25 on the shot clock for Texas State, who lead it by six. O.J. Black working against Burr. Gilder Tilbury dishes off. Montalvo steps inside the arc, and the 15-footer is good.
Yeah, Montalvo's really found the stroke here in the last couple of minutes for Texas State.
Has 9 points to lead all scores.
Had some clean looks at the basket. A great ball movement by the Bobcats.
McNeese will play for the final shot. O'Shea's got it way out high. Working on Roberson. Dished it off to Greenwood. We're down to three. Greenwood with a long two-point attempt is good. Put inside the arc, but Greenwood gets his 9 point just before the buzzer and makes it a six-point game in favor of Texas State at the intermission. So we've got 20 minutes in the books. And Texas State has the advantage 30-24. Stay tuned. Halftime activities coming your way next from Burton Coliseum as you watch Southland Conference basketball.
Thanks, son.
For more than 15 years, I've helped clients nationwide make solid decisions about investing in gold so they can enjoy what's most important.
Discover the best options for you and your family by calling 866-UCB-GUIDE to receive our award-winning gold guide free. 866-UCB-GUIDE, 866-822-4843.
Now is the time to learn about gold so you have time to enjoy what's most important.
McNeese is more than higher education. It's a place where engineering students develop robots to aid in disaster relief around the world. Where agriculture students and faculty work with physicians to conduct groundbreaking research in arthritis treatment. McNeese is more than a four-year college. It's a place to invest in yourself and create the life and future that you want. McNeese is more than a university. McNeese is home. Learn more at McNeese.edu.
At MidSouth Bank, we're dedicated to providing loans that allow our customers to achieve their business and personal dreams. That's one promise you can bank on. We're not just business associates, we're neighbors. We're committed to our customers and the strength of our local economy. Here at MidSouth Bank, responsibility matters. With locations in Texas and Louisiana and still growing, discover how our customers are finding strength in numbers at MidSouth Bank.
The Southland Conference is 4,200 student athletes from 13 member institutions competing in 17 NCAA Division I sports. We are Southland Strong.
Scores Texas State 30 and McNeese State 24. Tom Franklin, Neil Raphael with you here at courtside. And Neil, an interesting first half as we had an early start by McNeese State followed by a big run by Texas State.
Yeah, Texas State started to dominate the boards and they were able to pull out. And then McNeese State fires back in the last couple of minutes and hits some key shots to pull it close.
Let's take a look at some of the first half highlights from today's ballgame. 30-26 in favor of the Bobcats. Early on, you see Jemiah Burr with a three ball off the left corner. Transition three for Greenwood, the young freshman. Got McNeese out of the block fast. And then Texas State started to come back. First, Roberson.
They really did. They did a nice job of penetrating and getting to the glass and getting some easy looks.
There's a nice entry pass for McFerrin. Had a four-point opportunity there for Ethan Montalvo. Made the three and had the free throw to go on top of it.
Yeah, Montalvo had 9 points to lead the Bobcats in the first half.
Nice strong move to the basket there and follow by Gant. And Steven Ogochukwu coming off the bench for a couple of baskets to spark McNeese's comeback. They trailed by as many as 10 in the first half.
And there's Burr getting back in the action.
Montalvo, another nice step aside, three-pointer.
Great ball movement, as you see, by Texas State. Reaped great rewards in the first half.
And here's Black again with another floater off the glass. He really likes that move. So our halftime score is 30-24 in favor of the Texas State Bobcats. We'll have more of our halftime activities from Burton Coliseum right after we take timeout. Get out of here.
All right.
Bobcats on top of the Cowboys, 30-24 at halftime here at Burton Coliseum in Lake Charles. And we're pleased to be joined by Mike Fulgens, who is the president and title sponsor of our ball game today from Universal Coin and Bullion. Mike, thanks for so much for all your assistance.
Well, it's glad to support the Southland Conference and the fine institutions that are part of the Southland. Thanks for being here.
Well, you've got some Southland roots coming here as being a McNeese State alum, correct?
Alum here, and my kids went to Lamar University, so I really like the Southland. I believe it's Southland strong, as they say.
And you've been a longtime supporter of this McNeese State program. You've done a lot for them philanthropically and donations and stuff to build things up. What makes that important to you?
Well, I went here on scholarship as a student, and they gave me a scholarship and helped me get where I was. So I give back because they gave to me.
So tell us a little bit more about your involvement here with McNeese State, more than just putting on these broadcasts.
Well, I helped form the tip-off club here, and I helped with the McNeese Foundation. I've been involved in a lot of aspects here, and we brought Dick Vitale here twice. And it was
twice
we brought Dick in here. Great guy. When I wrote for the Sporting News, I got to know him. And Dick agreed to come in and was a great inspiration to the players and the fans.
Well, he's one of the biggest backers of college basketball you're going to find anywhere. And I'm sure he fit right in here in Cajun country, didn't he?
Oh, he did. We gave him the key to the city. We gave him the gumbo and crawfish etouffee treatment.
That'll get it done for you. As you take a look around here at McNeese State and you see the developments, we'll play here in Burton Coliseum, which is a nice facility, but most people know that when you have to move off campus, you lose a little bit of something, and the Cowboys are trying to change that, right?
Well, they're building a brand new facility. It'll open 2 years. It'll seat over 5,000. It's going to be a phenomenal on-campus facility, and it will augment the brand new football facility and training facility. You know, our Cowboys went 10-0 this year.
Absolutely.
They're number 4 seed. They got a bye. And our other conference team, Sam Houston, is whipping Southern Utah as we speak.
All right. Well, let's talk a little bit about Universal Coin and Bullion. Tell us about the company and what it does.
Well, we're one of the largest companies in the country. We've been recognized as having the Book of the Year and by Crime Stoppers and corporate awards from the police department. And we sell over $100 million in gold and precious metals a year, 130 employees, and we strongly support the Southland.
When it comes to selling coins and bullion, a lot of people don't know what they're getting into. Do you have advisors who can help them and get them in the right places?
Yes, and better than that, we give them the information they need to do well. Our materials have been voted the best in the nation 7 out of the last 10 years.
So if people want to get a hold of your company, what should they do?
Call Universal Coin and Bullion or go to universalcoin.com on the internet. We're glad to help them.
Or watch Southland Basketball Conference playoff action. You'll see their commercials here during the course of the broadcast, and that'll tell them too, right?
That will too.
Mike Fulgens, he is the president of Universal Coin and Bullion, our title sponsor of today's ballgame, joining us here at halftime. We're at Burton Coliseum, where Texas State leads McNeese State by a score of 30-24. We'll take a look at the first half stats right after this timeout. Neil Raphael joins me here at halftime, 30-24, of Texas State on top of McNeese State at the half. And Neil, let's take a look at some first half stats and find out how we got to this place after the first 20 minutes. There we go. Neither team lighting it up from the floor. 11 of 30 for Texas State, 9 of 25 for McNeese. Long range, not too much, but there's the big difference in the ball game. Rebounding 24-13 in favor of the Bobcats.
It provides second chance opportunities for Texas State, and I feel that's been the difference in this contest.
Now, Texas State did allow McNeese to get back in the game by turning it over 9 times in the first half. 8 fouls against McNeese to 4 for Texas State in the first half, so neither team really doing a whole lot from the free throw line. What do you think is going to have to happen here in the second half for either of these teams?
I think McNeese is going to have to do a better job on the boards. It was able to create some transition opportunities in the first half, and they're going to have to do a much better job of containing those boards.
It wouldn't hurt for either team to start feeling it from the floor. Neither team has been able to find the shooting range so far, so we'll see if somebody can get hot in the second half. Right now it's 30-24 as Texas State leads McNeese State. We'll be back with second half action from Burton Coliseum after this timeout. Back here at Burton Coliseum, we get ready to start the second half. Texas State on top by a score of 30-24. You look at some of the incidental numbers in the ball game. Points off turnovers, each team was 6. But where Texas State has built their advantage is they have 16-6 lead in points in the paint and 7-0 in second chance points, Neil.
Yeah, that's that disparity in the rebounds. That's provided many opportunities for Texas State.
8 offensive rebounds. They converted to 7 points. That's, you know, a little bit less than what coaches want. They would like it at least to be a 1-to-1 ratio, so they're pretty close the way it is right now. But they like to see them convert those opportunities a little bit better pace than they are. So McNeese has the basketball to start in the gold uniforms trimmed in blue and white, moving from left to right.
I'd like to see McNeese with a little more patience offensively in their shot selection.
Poche with a 3 from the right wing. Lance Poche with his first points of the ball game. Cuts the deficit in half to 30-27. And again, the pressure defense for the Cowboys. He had 13 points in the win over Dillard earlier this week and 7 rebounds, but that's his first basket of this ball game. Here's Gant blocked by McFerrin. Scramble for the loose ball, and it comes away to Greenwood. Another chance here for the Cowboys. Long-range bucket could tie the game. O'Shea drops it off. Burr, the little floater, left it short. And Black takes the rebound, went right into a double team and got away with it.
Yeah, I like the aggressiveness of McNeese right now.
Here's Roberson for Gant. Gant back outside for Black. Gilda Tilbury, pump fake, dishes back to Gant. The lefty is no good, but he got fouled, and it may have been Poche.
I was calling the Cowboys, Kevin Jackson.
Nope, Kevin Jackson, 21, who was on the other side.
Nice penetration and kick.
Saw Jackson on the shooting arm. He was on the left side. He got the foul. Poche was on the non-shooting arm. Gant's free throw is no good.
Texas State was 6 of 7 in the first half on the line.
One out of two for Gant, who has 5 points. And it's a 4-point lead for Texas State. Burr on the drive, and the pull-up from 10 is good by Jemiah Burr, who now has 7 points.
Yeah, nice crossover and the leaner by Burr.
Gilda Tilbury back to Black. Black got it across the line to Montalvo, and now back to Black, and they'll settle into their offense with 17 to shoot. Montalvo off the screen, will take the 2-point shot, put on the line, no good. Rebound cleared by Burr. And again, McNeese with a chance to either tie or go in front. Poche trying to work against Roberson, can't get by.
I like to see the ball in the hands of Burr. He really makes things happen for McNeese.
Here's Tevin Jackson. Spinner in the lane. Oh, what a nice move by Tevin Jackson.
Nice job by the big man of spinning on a dime and laying that one in. What dexterity.
His first point to the ballgame. Tie is at 31. Back to the basket goes Gant. He was fouled by Poche that time. So now Gant give Texas State the lead back. Imani Gant, as we told you, 11 points and 4 rebounds against UTEP, and they want him to be better in the other aspect of the game besides just scoring.
6-1 run by McNeese out of the gate here in the second half.
First free throw is good for Gant. Now 2 out of 3 from the line. He's been plagued by a little injury, has only appeared in one of their 3 outings. And that was the UTEP game a week ago. Made them both this time. So after the first miss, he's knocked home 3 in a row. He has 7 points. And the Bobcats have the lead back. Jackson was trying hard to post up against Roberson. They couldn't get it to him. And they'll go back outside to Poche instead. Here's Jackson off the screen for Burr. In the lane, rejected by Gant. And here comes Black for Texas State. Gant from the free throw line. Reward the big man for running, but he couldn't finish it off, and McFerrin will take it down for McNeese. Burr rejected again by Gant.
My goodness.
Montalvo ahead for Gilda Tilbury. Offensive foul.
Imani Gant.
Oh, it was Gant blocking out on the other side. It wasn't even Gilda Tilbury on the drive to the basket. It was Gant holding off underneath the basket. Let's see if we pick it up here. Watch on your left side. Oh, there's the push away.
Yeah.
There you saw it.
On the back side of everything.
So Gant got called for the foul, his first. So McNeese looking to take their first lead since early in the first half. They led it 8-2, and it's been all Texas State since. McFerrin dishes to Jackson, back out for Burr's three, and he got the friendly roll.
Nice inside-out game that time by McNeese. Collapsed down, kicked it out, and the jumper.
Second three of the ball game for Burr. He has 10, first player for either side in double figures. Under 16 minutes to go now. 1 point lead for the Cowboys. Black to the basket says not for long. I'll get it right back.
Nice first step by Black. It got him to the rim for two. That quick first step.
Tevin Jackson back to Burr. Hash mark on the far sideline. Here's McFerrin. Back out for Jackson's three. Straight on. Yes.
Back-to-back baskets for the Cowboys. Inside-out game.
And a two-point lead at 37-35. Roberson. Whoa. Just held on with the toes of that pivot foot. Here's Gant to the basket. Swatted by McFerrin. Gant got it back and got the follow. That's the way to stay with the basketball.
My goodness, on both ends of the floor here in the second half, Gann is getting it done.
Seems like the overall intensity for both teams is jacked up here in the second 20 minutes. Off the glass is Greenwood, no good. Gant tips the rebound. Montalvo had it poked out of his hands by Greenwood. It'll stay with Texas State when we come back. 14:49 to play, and we've got a good one here at Burton Coliseum in Lake Charles, Louisiana. All tied up at 37 apiece, the Bobcats and the Cowboys.
Diversification is important and means more than owning different stocks. Hi, I'm Mike Fulgens, president of Universal Coin and Bullion. I've been helping clients nationwide for 15 years diversify with gold. And I want to send you a free copy of our award-winning gold guide to help you choose the best gold options for you.
Get the answers you need about gold. Call us today at 866-UCB-GUIDE. That's 866-822-4843.
McNeese is more than higher education. It's a place where engineering students develop robots to aid in disaster relief around the world. Where agriculture students and faculty work with physicians to conduct groundbreaking research in arthritis treatment. McNeese is more than a four-year college. It's a place to invest in yourself and create the life and future that you want. McNeese is more than a university. McNeese is home. Learn more at McNeese.edu.
The Southland Conference is 4,200 student athletes from 13 member institutions competing in 17 NCAA Division I sports. We are Southland Strong.
.14:49 to play, deadlocked at 37, Texas State and McNeese State. McNeese has found the shooting touch here in the second half as they are 5 of 9, including 3 for 3 from long range to draw back in this game, outscoring Texas State 13-7 to get things started and knotting the game at 37 apiece. Rebounds, however, still favor Texas State by a 29-16 margin.
Yeah, I just think the aggressive nature coming out of the half by McNeese State has paid big dividends so far.
See Dave Simmons and his staff sitting there. Long time McNeese guy. Assistant coach at one time. Head coach here for a decade. The Bobcats with the ball. They break the pressure in the backcourt and now settle into their offense with 15 to shoot. Here's Gant way out high. And we get a foul away from the ball. Greenwood guilty of the foul. His second. Third team foul here in the second half against the Cowboys. New 30 seconds for Texas State. They'll inbound to the right of the basket. Down low for Gilda Tilbury. Swatted away from behind by Poche. And the rebound comes out to McFerrin. Poche getting his hand in there and swatting that thing away. So here's Burr trying to hold off Black. Dish into the corner. Three ball is short by Malvo, who came in at the timeout. And we get a foul on the rebound.
It's going to be on Greenwood.
Greenwood with two quick fouls here.
Yeah, 50-50 ball, and Greenwood
didn't block out his man.
No, he did push Montalvo in the back.
Montalvo was the shooter and Greenwood was the defender. It didn't keep him out there. 6 minutes gone by. All even at 37 here. And illegal screen on Gant is going to be the call. Andrew Walton with a foul. And with his second foul, both here in the second half. Watch him move on trying to set the screen. He didn't get set. Izugo Chukwu came in and hit the screen and drew the blocking foul. So four fouls against McNeese to just two for Texas State. That could factor in as we go on here. Burr, floater, off the glass, no good. Black with the rebound for Texas State. Gilda Tilbury, pump fake drive, cut off on the baseline. In the lane for Black's little teardrop that's good. Black is really, really good in the paint, Neil. I'm very impressed with his moves down there for a little guy. Nice move to the basket by Hugo Chukwu. He's got six, and he's been a nice spark off the bench for Dave Simmons.
Yeah, did a nice job of posting up and spinning right to the rim.
Now down to 13 minutes to play, and a foul down low as Roberson tried to get inside.
Both teams are doing a nice job of cutting to the basket here in the second half and paying big dividends.
Poche picks up his third foul. Let's see if we can pick it up here. There you see Poche with the body from behind. Oh, bad inbounds pass goes off of Ramlal and taken away by Poche. Here comes Burr, back to Poche. Hugo Chukwu, oh, he was saying he got hit on the shot. It came up way short, just drew nylon underneath and goes out of bounds.
You know how that is. Let's take a look. That from deep. That's deep. Didn't get his legs involved at all. You know those big guys, they always like to step out and see if they can make a three, Tom.
You know, when you're 6'7", 220 pounds, why do you have to shoot from 25 feet? I never got it.
Everybody wants to be a guard.
Oh, and there's the drive by Montalvo, but it's before the shot, so wave off the basket. James Harvey gets called for the foul. Take a look here.
Yeah, he's got a quick step. Montalvo does a nice job of keeping defenders off balance.
Wipe out the basket even though it went in. So we're still tied at 39. New 30 for Texas State. Black looking to get it in. Finally got it to Roberson just in time. Now Black working on Jackson. Montalvo against the big man. Got it swatted away by both big guys. Ahead it comes, but intercepted by Black. They were looking for Harvey, who was running the floor.
Now the problem, Jackson had one hand on the ball. And
Montalvo out to Roberson. Here's Black from 18.
Yeah, great ball movement that time by Texas State. And ends the basket from Black.
Black has 10, six of those here in the second half, and the Bobcats back on top by a deuce. Burr and Black, it's been nice to watch those two guys match up that we featured in the pregame.
I think they're gonna call a hold.
It's gonna be on Roundell. As we get to a timeout with 11:39 to play, Texas State still on top, but only by two here at Burton Coliseum. 41-39. Texas State with a two-point advantage led by O.J. Black with 10 points, 9 apiece for Imani Gantz and Ethan Montalvo. For McNeese State, they're faced by Jemiah Burr, who's got 10 points, and 9 points for Jaron Greenwood. But as you talked about earlier, these teams like to spread it around. Not one guy will take off. You'll see a little guy for a little bit, and then it'll go to somebody else. Here's Harvey for three. Off the back iron, no good. Rebound tip, but tracked down in the corner by Roberson. And Texas State will come back with a two-point lead. Montalvo has hit a couple from long range. Gives it up this time, and Black gets it back on the right wing. Inside, spinning, Roberson was blocked. And away comes McNeese State.
Austin Lewis. Big block, two-handed stuff.
Now Burr will try and set things up. 11 minutes to play. Basket by the Cowboys can tie or put them in front. Trying to play pick and roll. Burr drops it in the lane. Jump hook is no good by Ugo Chukwu, and away comes Texas State. Ahead it goes for Ram Lau. Once on the floor and off the glass with the left hand.
A nice lead pass that time by Texas State. Finish at the rim by Ram Lau.
Kendall Ram Lau, his fourth point of the ball game. Four-point lead for the Bobcats. Jackson gives it up on the wing for Harvey. Harvey back to Jackson. Shot clock is down to 7. Jackson drives. We get a foul down low with a hand. The foul is on Roberson. His second. And the fourth team foul.
Impeded progress there did Roberson.
So Rob Lowell's got it as they reset the shot clock. See if the Cowboys can get that lead. They had the quick start at 8-2. Behind the back went Jackson and lost it. Had his pocket picked by Montalvo. And the follow is no good. And you see Montalvo saying, how did I miss that?
He made such a solid move to the basket.
Let's take a look at it here. There's the steal.
Yeah, picked the pocket. Double clutch.
Left it short. Ball knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Tevin Jackson. So the Bobcats will throw it in the backcourt. And Anthony Roberson will track it down. 6'5 junior. Didn't play against UTEP last Saturday, suffering from a little viral condition. They left him home so he wouldn't infect the rest of the team. Nice head and shoulder fake and drive to the basket. Kevin Gilder Tilbury lays it in for 2-1.
Found the gap on the offside. There we go. The big first lead step and finishes it at the glass. Tilbury. Good skills for a 6'7 guard. That's one thing I've noticed. These big forwards slash centers have really good ball handling skills. Tevin Jackson also on the other side for McNeese does a nice job of handling the ball.
One thing he has done today that head coach Dave Casper wants to see him do more of. Well, he missed the free throw on the three-point opportunity, but Texas State keeps it alive. But he is only 1-for-7 from the floor. And Casper says oftentimes he lets that affect the rest of his game. He has remained aggressive both on both ends of the floor today. So that's something that Danny Casper is very proud of.
There's the reverse.
And here he goes to the basket again.
Yep, against the multitude there. Sometimes you just have to pull up a little short, Tom, and kiss it off the glass because sometimes you don't get the call you want.
4 out of 6 from the line in the ball game is Gilder Tilbury. He's got 2 more here. Makes this one for his 9th point of the game. Craig McFerrin and Lance Poche back in for McNeese State.
Tilbury right at his average, 9 points on the season.
And just like that, He's in double figures with 10. The Bobcats are back out to an 8-point advantage with 9 minutes and 10 seconds to play. McNeese just couldn't get over the hump. They got tied, but that's all they could do. Harvey dishes off on the baseline. Here's Poche. Had it knocked away. Got it back. Lost it. Montalvo with a steal. Here's Black. 2-on-2 for the trailing Montalvo. Over the head pass for Ram Lal. Ball bounced around Roberson. Out to Gilder Tilbury. The three won't go. Tough rebound inside by Austin Lewis.
Multiple opportunities that time for Texas State to score.
They may regret not cashing in on that opportunity later. See if McNeese can capitalize here. Here's McFerrin off the left block. Outside, Poche's three. In and out, no good. Roberson pulls down the rebound. Back come the Bobcats. Gilder Tilbury to the basket. He'll lay it in for two. Took a spill, but got it in. He's got a dozen to lead all scores.
And Tilbury very relentless.
And we get a drive and we get a foul away from the ball.
A little extracurricular activity.
Gilder Tilbury and McFerrin.
McFerrin.
The official stepping in between both.
Sharing some pleasantries.
It's on Gilder Tilbury, his first. 15 foul. And suddenly the buzzer is stuck. Now we got it unstuck. Okay.
Into the game for McNeese, 6-7 freshman from Houston, number 3.
Hey, Tils. For McNeese, Adrian Brown. Checks in, makes his first appearance, number 30. The officials doing a nice job of settling play down here. So this doesn't get out of hand.
Exactly.
Byron Jarrett, John St. Clair, and Andrew Walton. See a veteran officiating crew when they do something like this. They nip things in the bud. The inbounds pass deflected off the hands of McFerrin. First touch by Gilder Tilbury, and then off McFerrin's hands and out of bounds. Turnover, McNeese brings the ball back to Texas State with 8:09 left. And their lead by 10. That equals their biggest lead of the game.
Yeah, an 8-0 run in the last 2 minutes, Tom, by Texas State.
Here's Black to the basket. High off the glass and softly in.
Nice drive. He does a nice job of extending and getting the ball above his shoulder away from the defender.
Biggest lead of the game. And here's Brown off the bench with a free throw line jumper to cut it back to 10 at 51-41. 7:35 left.
Nice stroke by Adrian Brown.
Gilder Tilbury fake the three. Will drive to the basket. Reverse layup for two. Was that pretty? He's got 8 of his 14 here in the second half. Down low for Brown. Knocked out of his hands. Recovered by McFerrin. Jump stop. Right hander is good.
Nice answer by McNeese.
First pass through the second half for McFerrin, who's got 6. Down to 7 minutes to play in a 10-point game. Bobcats spotted McNeese an early 6-point lead, but have been in control since then. We've had a couple of ties along the way, but that's as close as McNeese would get. Here's Ram Lal. He misses from 10. Rebound comes down to Poche, and here come the Cowboys once again. In the corner is Harvey. Pull-up jumper from the right angle is good. Jaron Greenwood in double figures now with 11 for the Cowboys.
McNeese really needs a stop here, Tom.
Right now the guy with the hot hand is Gilder Tilbury. Let's see if they can get him free. He's down on the baseline, has it. Cut off by Poche.
You've got a...
And a timeout.
Texas State
will come with 6 minutes and 8 seconds to play. And the Bobcats owning an 8-point lead over the Cowboys here at Burton Coliseum. 8-point lead for the Bobcats from Texas State. Shooting it at 41% on 20 of 49. Meanwhile, McNeese, the home team, at 40% on 18 of 45. Long range, McNeese 6 of 16. Texas State 2 of 9. But Texas State getting to the free throw line as they've been there 14 times and capitalized on 11. Hello, everybody. How are you? Nice to see you. Hope you had a great Thanksgiving.
And speaking of eight, Tom, that's how many points Gilder Tilbury has had here in the second half. Now he has 14 points in this contest and really done a nice job here in the second half.
But you talk about the balance they have. 14 for Gilda Tilbury, 12 for Black, 9 apiece for Montalvo and Gant. That's really spreading it around. Here's Montalvo from 2, they say. Foot on the line, but the basket is good by Ethan Montalvo, his first of the second half.
That's fundamentally sound is Montalvo. A nice job of catching the ball and moving, creating his own shot.
5:40 left now. Time becoming the enemy of the Cowboys as well as the Bobcats. And the longer they take to get into a play, the tougher it becomes. Pump fake by Poche. He'll drop it off down low, and the ball goes out of bounds. Brings us to another timeout. We have 5 minutes, 24 seconds to go. And it's a 10-point lead for the Bobcats. You know, we touched upon it a little bit earlier. The NCAA had put into effect over 25 different rule changes to help the men's game and the pace of play during the offseason to start play in 2015 and 2016. And here are some of them for you. The shot clock, they reduced for 5 seconds like we talked about. They reduced the number of timeouts the teams can have. They only have 3 30-second timeouts in 160 now as opposed to 4 30s. They move that restricted arc. You may see the two arcs underneath the basket from 3 feet to 4 feet. And to make the job of the officials calling block charges on drives to the basket a little bit easier. We talked about the coaches only being able to call timeouts on a dead ball situation. They've eliminated the 5-second closely guarded count, which I thought was a tough rule for officials to enforce. How close does a guy have to get? Where on the floor is he before he's closely guarded? But maybe the next one, they're trying to get rid of the flop, as officials may now penalize players for faking a foul.
I agree with that one. I think it's much overdue, and it'll make it a lot easier on everybody.
You know, I've heard conversation on that elimination of the 5-second closely guarded rule, talk on both sides. One, that it was hard to enforce, but otherwise, if you have a tight ball game coming down in the final 2 minutes and you're playing tough on the ball defense, you don't get that call and can force a turnover on the other team that way now. So there are pros and cons to both of them. It's going to be interesting to watch these rule changes as the season goes on.
We'll see how they play out, and we'll see if there are any adjustments made at the end of the season. I'm sure the coaches will have quite a bit of input on those.
I would think that they should, yes. So now we're down to 5:10 to play, and a 10-point lead for the Bobcats. And Gilder Tilbury lost the ball on the drive. Burr takes the basket with the left hand. He got fouled. The flyby, Montalvo, pick up the foul.
Nice job by Jemiah Bird. We'll see, tell if it went off his foot or he just lost control. And Burr on the other end and took it right to the rim and drew the foul on Montalvo.
So you have Jemiah Burr. Free throw off the back iron, no good. His first appearance at the line. 81% are coming in. And missed them both. Rebound controlled underneath by Gant.
Very uncharacteristic.
Well, that's something the Cowboys can ill afford to happen. They need to take advantage of the clock not moving with a chance to score points. They let that one go by. We're down to 4:50 now. Gant trying to back his way in. Double team. The left-hander is no good, but the putback is good underneath. Roberson.
An ill-advised shot by Gant, but again, Texas State continuing to dominate the boards on the offensive side of
Burr
things.
Burr in the lane got fouled by Black. So Burr's going to go to the line. See it here, just the body by Black getting in the way. The foul on the shot attempt by Burr. You know, Anthony Roberson, an athletic kid, good rebounder. His older brother Andre played at the University of Colorado. Now plays for the Oklahoma City Thunder in the NBA. Playing alongside Durant and Westbrook in that crowd. That's not bad.
What a combination. New coach Billy Donovan. Doing a nice job with that crew.
So Burr found his stroke after missing two the last time. Knocks two down this time to make it a 10-point game with 4:29 left. And McNeese trying to extend the pressure all 94 feet. But Roberson, you see the athleticism, will get it out to Black, and Black will move it across the line into front court. Burr watching out for the screen from Gant. Got around it. Montalvo back outside to Black. Black will move it around in the lane. The jump stop is blocked by McFerrin. Loose ball comes out, recovered by Gant. Shot clock is down to three. Gant gives it up on the wing. Gilder Tilbury missed the three ball. Flies in for the rebound and got the putback. He came from out of nowhere.
10 points in the second half by Tilbury.
He might have been in one of the casinos when he let that shot go and come flying in for that baby.
10 of his 16.
Here's Bird back outside. Brown shot is off the mark, no good. McFerrin the rebound. His putback attempt is no good, but he got fouled.
But again, Tom, I feel the difference in the game is second and third chance opportunities has really put McNeese in a tough situation.
They are in the driver's seat, are the Bobcats from Texas State. They lead by a dozen with 3:38 left as you watch Southland Conference basketball from Burton Coliseum.
About diversifying with gold but don't know how? Hi, I'm Mike Fulgens, president of Universal Coin and Bullion. As an award-winning nationwide dealer, we help clients get the answers they need to discover the beauty, security, and strength of gold in their portfolio.
Call us today at 866-UCB-GUIDE to receive our award-winning gold guide free. That's 866-822-4843.
McNeese is more than higher education. It's a place where engineering students develop robots to aid in disaster relief around the world. Where agriculture students and faculty work with physicians to conduct groundbreaking research in arthritis treatment. McNeese is more than a four-year college. It's a place to invest in yourself and create the life and future that you want. McNeese is more than a university. McNeese is home. Learn more at McNeese.edu.
The Southland Conference is 4,200 student athletes from 13 member institutions competing in 17 NCAA Division I sports. We are Southland Strong.
Here, Texas State has a 12-point lead with 3:38 to play over the McNeese State Cowboys. Elsewhere in Southland Conference action today, in basketball, Southeastern Louisiana and Arkansas Pine Bluff knotted up at 28 apiece in the first half. And then the third quarter in football, Southern Utah with a 39-26 lead over Sam Houston State. That time of the year when the sports overlap a little bit, keep everybody busy. Free throw attempt by McFerrin is no good.
One shot, one.
Wow. McFerrin 0-4, Tom, during this contest.
So McFerrin misses them both. Can ill afford to have that happen. Little side note on the football game as Black drives the basket and lays it in with the right hand. Now has 14. The winner of that Sam Houston State Southern Utah game plays here against McNeese State, the fourth overall seed, who got a first round bye today and is sitting back with their feet propped up, watching the two go at it head to head. So they called the foul on Black, and that's four fouls now on Black. Something Texas State needs to be careful of as Burr makes the first free throw for his 13th point of the game. And rolls the second one in off the front iron. 61-49 with 3:14 to go.
Every one of these free throws is crucial for McNeese at this point.
Black double teamed in backcourt. Got it across the line for Roberson. Down to 3 minutes to play now. Montalvo circulates it on the far side for Gilda Tilbury. He has been a force here in the second half with 9 points. Black with a big step, jump stop, tried to pass it down low, and they didn't get it away. The shot clock violation, good defense by McNeese State.
It's the first
Lance
one
Poche
we've seen
will
today.
Come back in, yeah. He comes in for Adrian Brown, who had a basket in his time on the floor. 2:43 left, time of the essence, as McNeese trails by a dozen. Wouldn't hurt to dial long distance a couple of times here. A drive by Greenwood doesn't go. Had a three-point opportunity there, and Montalvo picks up the foul.
Yeah, once you're already elevated like that, not the time to foul. Nice quick move.
Coming from behind.
Yeah, they're going to call that every time.
So Greenwood to the line. Got the first one to roll softly through. Greenwood now 2 out of 3 from the stripe as part of his 12 points. 2:35 left. He can make it a 10-point game with the second. And does.
More full court pressure by McNeese.
1-2-2. Poche running the point on that defense. Sam Houston with a dangerous cross-court pass to Gilder Tilbury, and Gant will finish it with a left hand.
And that's what you have to do. You have to make them pay when they press you. Nice 2-on-1 finish at the rim for Texas State.
Approaching 2:10 left and still a 12-point lead. Burr, tough through the land of the Giants. A putback is good by Poche, and he'll have a 3-point opportunity. And if it's on Black, he's gone. He is.
Wow. Offensive rebounds have been hard to come by, but couldn't come at a more opportune time for McNeese State.
And especially against that guy, as Black picked up 4 of his 5 fouls here in the second half. That's going to bring KJ Malvo back in the game. So Black fouls out with 2:08 left. And his team on top by 10.
Well, and that's something we talked about, is getting to know your team and getting to know what they'll do under pressure situations, especially early in the season, Tom. And with your leader on the bench, we'll see.
Poche missed the free throw, but he's going to get a second chance. Lane violation against Texas State. Either Gant or Gilda Tilbury, a little quick across the line. I think I'm seeing hear him say 21, which would be Gant. And he missed it anyway. Long down the floor for Roberson, went out of his reach.
Yeah, a little snowboarding that time by Texas State and took his eyes off the ball.
Gilda Tilbury slapping the floor saying, man, we can't give that up like that. 2 minutes to go, 10-point game. Greenwood muscles up, didn't have enough spin. Rebound comes down to Gant, fouled. Greenwood, I think, reaching in. He was tied up with Tevin Jackson.
Greenwood his fourth.
So Gant will go back to the free throw line. Let's watch it again here as they fight for the rebound. Gant snatches it, and you see Greenwood come from behind trying to steal it away. So Gant with 11 points in the ball game.
Bobby Condon will check back in for Texas State.
Bobby Conley will come back in for Texas State, as Malvo will sit down. 1:53 to go. One and one, no good. Rebound. Gant fought for it, took it away, lost it, but Gilda Tilbury will recover.
Another 50-50 ball for Texas State.
Gilda Tilbury gives it up for Roberson. And now for Malvo. Malvo, crossover, back outside. Shot clock is down to 7. Gilder Tilbury with the runner, couldn't get it to fall. Loose ball taken away, though, by Gant. Gant through the lane and back outside. Smart by the big man. Oh. They have enough points. They just want to kill the clock. And a reach in on Burr will be his second. We'll send the freshman Malvo to the free throw line for the first time tonight. Hasn't been to the line this season. What a smart heads-up play by Gant, knowing the time was the better thing to kill than get points.
There were 28 seconds on the clock when he came down with it. Had the wherewithal to back it out and run some clock.
The young freshman Malvo misses the free throw.
That's good coaching, you know?
Well, we mentioned Danny Casper's teams. They know what to do. They have been well-schooled. One out of two for Malvo from the free throw line. Makes an 11-point game, 64-53. 1:15 left. McNeese has got to go in a hurry. And Burr was swatted away by Gant again. Here's Gilda Tilbury. Gives it up in the lane for Gant. He's hammered from behind by McFerrin. And Gant will go to the line with 1:03 left. Farron picking up his second foul.
Got to reward the big man for running the floor that time. And
you know, when I talked with Danny Casper yesterday, we mentioned that he's got the offensive skills and the athleticism to be a first-team all-conference player in the Sun Belt. He needs to round out his game. Well, I think we've seen him play some good defense and make some good rebounds and blockouts tonight and improve that part of his game in today's contest.
Yeah, he filled out the scorecard nicely.
Dozen points now for Gant. One more free throw here. And he's got them both. Look at this balance. 16 for Gilda Tilbury, 14 for Black, and 13 for Gant. Poche with a basket. We go under a minute to play and a foul in backcourt.
It's going to be on Tevin Jackson.
Tried to trap in the corner.
Kevin Jackson is third personal foul to shot.
So we'll get free throws at the other end, down to 55.6 seconds to go.
Big man from Plano, Texas, 6'11", Austin Evans checking in for Texas State.
And Gilda Tilbury misses the first. Went to Plano High School. Gant will sit down with a well-earned day's rest. One out of two for Gilda Tilbury. He's got 17 now. Down to 50 seconds to go. Greenwood's long three is no good. Gilda Tilbury with another rebound. Double team to the backcourt and fouled. He'll go to the free throw line again. It's on Burr. It'll be his third. Got another substitution coming up off the bench for Texas State. Roberson coming over to talk to him. He may be the guy getting subbed, or if Gilda Tilbury makes both free throws, or at least the second one, he'll get his breather. In and out, no good.
Yeah, they always miss the first one and make the second when they know they're coming out. Tom, I don't know why that is.
Roberson did go out, and D'Angelo West, 6'2 freshman, checks in for the Bobcats.
Oh,
missed them both. Well, he's not going to get a breather. We do have a man on the at the scorer's table, and that is Malcolm McCray. Second chance opportunity is good by Adrian Brown, and he'll get an and one opportunity.
Foul's going to be on Evans.
Evans picks up his first. Both teams in the double bonus. There is Malcolm McCray. He will come in, and Gilda Tilbury will get to sit down with his game-high 17 points. The job well done. See if Brown can complete the three-point opportunity. He does. 8-point game, 37.8. Texas State still needs to execute. Oh, and we get a foul away from the ball. It's going to be on Burr over the back of Malvo, and Malvo will get to shoot two here. Let's watch it underneath. You saw Burr with the reach around attempt. So Malvo is 1-2 from the line a moment ago. Back at it again with 37.8 to go. For Texas State, they will be home against UTSA on Wednesday night before going down to Corpus Christi to meet A&M Corpus Christi a week from tonight. For McNeese, they are off until December the 9th. Or check that. They have a game coming up on Monday at Central Michigan. Then they're off until December 9th. Three ball for Burr. Puts him up to 17 and ties him with Gilder Tilbury for game scoring honors. And a timeout called by McNeese with 32.7 to go. An 8-point game at 69-61. So what do you think these teams have learned here, Neil, as we count it down for the final 32 seconds of this ball game? What Danny Casper learned about his Texas State team today?
Well, pretty balanced ball club here when everybody's, you know, fairly healthy. Great contribution off the bench. He can go 8 or 9 deep, it looks like. McNeese State shot so poorly in the first half, it kind of put them in a hole. They were able to come back in the second half, shoot a little bit better, but my goodness, Texas State has really dominated the boards today, and second chance opportunities have really been the difference in this contest. So McNeese is going to have to do a much better job on the boards.
Malvo double teamed in backcourt near the baseline. Got it ahead, stolen away by Harvey. In the corner for Greenwood's three. Off the mark, no good. Rebound tipped around, controlled by Texas State. Control there by Courtney Julian, who checked in. Here's Malvo, down to 15 seconds to go. Oh, he threw the long pass ahead for Austin Evans and threw it too far, even though he's 6'11". And you hear, you may be able to hear the McNeese State fan over there chanting, "What was that?"
Oh, Burr gosh.
With a deep three. He's got 20. Another timeout for McNeese.
Then he sat right down on Malvo. He said, "Hey, I need a breather here. Coach, call timeout."
Watch this.
Look at that.
The pump fake and the shot.
My goodness. That's a pressure shot.
8.2 seconds to go. Meanwhile, as McNeese State, Dave Simmons tries to work in four freshmen and two other new players. What came out of this game for them that he can take forward to their game against Central Michigan on Monday night?
Well, got to take care of the basketball, number one. I think in the first half, as far as quality of shots, I think they can do a little bit better as far as finding better shots offensively. Better ball reversal, more penetration to the basket. Some of the things that they did a little bit better in the second half.
So 8 seconds to go. Quick inbounds. Gilda Tilbury checked back in, as did Roberson, and he is fouled by Harvey. So Roberson will go to the free throw line for the second time tonight. He's got 7 points. Trying to finish this off. I guess since we're talking basketball here, a tragic incident for the entire world of college basketball on Thanksgiving Day with the passing of legendary University of Houston coach Guy V. Lewis at the age of 93. You know, I don't know if college basketball would be as popular, especially in the big settings, the Final Fours and whatnot, without Guy V. Lewis's vision back in 1968 when he convinced John Wooden to come play his Houston team with Elvin Hayes and at the Astrodome.
Not just convinced him, they beat him.
Yep, 71-69. Yeah. Roberson goes 1-for-2 from the stripe.
Really the first large venue basketball game of its kind.
You know, before that, the game was televised in small arenas, 4,000 or 5,000, no matter where you played the game. And not only that, not only was it the first game played in the big venue, it was the first game with a national TV contract. The whole nation got to see it. What a game between two of the best teams going at the time, Lou Alcindor and UCLA and Elvin Hayes and the University of Houston. You know, where would basketball be without Guy V. Lewis? And it took him a long time to be inducted into the Naismith Hall of Fame, but they finally got around to doing it in 2013. glad the coach was alive, and so were his players. And our best to the Lewis family in this tough time for them.
Yeah, they finally got it right. Took them long enough.
Yeah, even John Wooden said, he said he took, you know, they neglected the fact, you know, they put too much emphasis on the fact that he never won a national championship, even though he went to five Final Fours. Here's Burr with another three at the buzzer. And he will finish with 24 points, but our final score is Texas State 70 and McNeese State 62. Or 68, rather, is the score up on the board. 70 to 68 is our final. Texas State with a 2-1 record now, and McNeese State drops to 1-4. We'll come back and see if we can have a word with head coach Danny Casper of the winning Texas State Bobcats after we pause for this timeout. Welcome back to Burton Coliseum, where the Texas State Bobcats have improved their record to 2-1 on the season with a 70-68 win over the McNeese State Cowboys, who fall to 1-4 on the year. Tom Franklin, Neil Raphael, joined now by the winning head coach, Danny Casper of Texas State. And I guess for the first 38 minutes, you were pretty pleased with the way your team played.
You know, we made too many turnovers first half, but defensively, we were doing a pretty good job. And we were rebounding the ball well. We just were turning it over and we're actually missing some easy shots, I thought. But the second half, they closed with a flurry. I hope our guys learned a lot from that right there, because that's a good lesson.
You were led by Kevin Gilder-Tilbury with 17 points in the ball game. And when we talked yesterday, you told me that he's a kid, when his shot's not going, may tend to drop his shoulders every once in a while. Tonight, he didn't do that. He really went at it for a full 40 minutes.
I was very pleased with the way Kevin played, and I thought O.J. Black did a good job for us. He got some silly fouls there at the end. And, so we had some kids really do a good job contributing. We need some more help from off the bench. Our bench did not do a good job tonight. And that's the whole score at the end.
Second chance opportunities were big for y'all. What else could you tell me you learned about your team today?
Well, they won without Imani Gant really playing very well tonight. Yeah, I know he had 11 or 13, but I didn't think he played very well. And we actually, his backup did not play very well, but we had some people come through for us. And again, I thought our defense was pretty good. And so I learned our defense is maybe a little bit further along. But even some of the turnovers we made, they were open shots, and they traveled when they tried a shot fake or, you know, so far. Just like that long pass for a layup there at the end of the game. That's a layup if we catch it.
Absolutely. Well, congratulations, Coach, moving to 2-1. You got UTSA at home on your next adventure on Wednesday.
We do, December 2nd. I hope all you Bobcat fans come out and watch us play.
All right, that's the winning head coach, Danny Casper of the Texas State Bobcats. They win it by a score of 70-68. That's all from Burton Coliseum here in Lake Charles, Louisiana, as the Cowboys fall to 1-4. Great job done here by our crew, our camera crew, for Neil Raphael and for winning coach Danny Casper. Tom Franklin saying so long for Burton Coliseum, and we'll see you next time as we bring you more Southland Conference basketball.